Very good morning to one and all. See, we are going to learn the remaining part of the topic, that is environment. It's the last part in which we are going to learn two major concepts. One, the ozone depletion, and another is the disposal of garbage waste. See, we know that today there is a lot of impact is there on human onto the environment. In that, the first impact is the ozone depletion, and the second is the garbage waste which we are going to produce. Let's come to the first, the ozone depletion. See, the ozone depletion is that we know that ozone is that now, that is what commonly called it as the O3. See, this ozone is that it is a protective layer to the earth, which is protecting the what we call the ultraviolet rays which are coming from the sunlight. From that, the earth is going to be protected. If suppose that this ultraviolet rays or the ozone is that of the O3 directly enters into the earth surface, what will happen? The people will suffer from various disorders. Especially the humans will get a disease called as a cataract. Not only that, the mutational changes are there in the DNA. Not only that, the skin cancer. These are the sort of disorders are there which we can see during the what we call as a the ozone if entered into the animal. Not only that, in addition to this, this O3 is that it's a poisonous. Poisonous means in the case of what we call as an when it enters into the crust. Otherwise, it is not poisonous into the what we call because it is a protective layer to the earth. Not only that, see there is a what we call lot of products are there today which we are using. See there is a what we call certain rules have made to the what we call stop the what we call this or what we call depletion of ozone. CFC is the main what we call cause that it is a synthetic what we call chemical is there which we are continuously using. It is a synthetic chemical is there and which we are using continuously. And in the year 1987, the International Union of what we call environmental, they said that we have to ban the use of the what we call CFC products. And the companies who manufacture the CFC products, they have to be stopped manufacturing the CFC what we call refrigerators or the what we call fire extinguishers. And in the year 1986, an amendment has been made where there is no production of the what we call as the CFC what we call contains what we call refrigerators and the fire extinguishers. Due to which the ozone is there now. Today we are seeing that people say that the ozone get in a particular hole because of the more and more use of the CFC product. So we have to stop using the what we call these CFC products. Otherwise, what happens in the coming years? We see that if ozone gets depleted and this ozone is a thin layer or a membrane is there surrounding the earth which is protecting from the ultraviolet rays which are coming from the sun. If it is not there, then what will happen? It is going to affect the what we call not only the human beings, in addition to this, plants, animals, everything going to be affected. That's why we have to what we call protect the ozone. And this ozone is that now generally it is made up of in a what we call two molecules of an oxygen. Generally we say that the oxide is that of O2 and the O and it combines it gives an O3. And this will all take place in the environment in the upper what we call atmosphere. Generally it will not happen in the lower stratosphere of the what we call atmosphere. Generally it happens in the higher what we call atmosphere. So this is the one concept. And based on this, they have asked an activity. What is the activity? Now we have to collect an information from the internet or the library regarding the what we call as an the ozone which is going to be depleted. What are the chemicals are there which may lead to the depletion of the ozone? That is the one. And another, we have collected information that the ozone, the O3 which we are saying that how much big the holes are there into the ozone. So regarding that and which chemicals are responsible for the what we call depletion of the ozone. Regarding that, we have to collect a certain information. Now in this, let's come to the another aspect, that is what we call as an regarding the garbage waste. See, we know that in our city, there is a large amount of the waste is going to come. Not only the city, we can take in a classroom as an example. Thank you. These are generally called as the products. Then there is another what we call another introduction of the things is that today we are using the paper cups instead of the what we call as the plastic cups or the clay cups. That is what we call as a product. So today the people have shifted towards the what we call the paper cups. And due to this, what happens? This is easy to dispose, and the people can drink the what we call cups in the regular use. So like that. Thank you.